Hi, I'm Jordi, I'm editor of Daily Economy, and here with me I've got Nick Razey, CEO of Next Generation Data, Europe's largest data center company. Hi, thanks a lot for talking to me. You've recently sold the large majority stake to Infravia Capital Partners for £100 million. How has that changed since July last year? Changed the company roadmap?
So, Infravia is an infrastructure fund, and they see data centers as an infrastructure asset. So, in 10, 15 years' time, like a bridge or a road, data centers will still be here. So, they see this as a long-term asset, and we share that view. So, they're investing in the future. They're not looking for dramatic overnight success. They believe this is a long-term program. And what's changed for us, two things that they wanted to see. Firstly, they wanted to do what they call institutionalize the company, by which I guess they mean solidify the management team, make sure the processes are in place, set the platform for growth. And then the second thing is grow the business. They are a $1 billion fund, you know, they have a lot of ambition in the sector, and they're looking for us to grow the business.
But why would they choose Next Generation Data over other competitions out there?
So, I think they believe in our model, and our model is to be outside the M25, to focus on space and power, and a low cost base. We have a fantastic asset here, and a fantastic scope for growth, and they believe in that.
It's actually interesting the ambition of the M25. What's sort of the landscape outside the motorway, outside London, across the UK?
So, as you know, the data centre market has always been focused around London. There are many reasons for that, but historically it was because connectivity was so expensive. Certainly today, connectivity is not a major factor. Nonetheless, a lot of people prefer to be around London and the M55, and it's normally around being close to their equipment. It's about convenience. Having said that, there's 10-15% of the market are quite happy not to be in the M25, and once you come outside the M25, there aren't that many options. So, unlike London, where there may be 10, 20 companies fighting for every piece of business, for every customer that comes outside the M25, there's probably us and maybe one or two others.
And then, of course, being a UK competitor, there's a lot of concession around Brexit. What have you seen changing around? Theresa May about to trigger for 50. What's going around with the topic of Brexit and data center space?
Well, it's a long question, really. I mean, I was against Brexit, and I think the effects will be long term. I think in 10, 20 years' time, it will have been overall a bad thing for our economy. But not particularly a bad thing for the data center sector. You know, there may be negotiations around import and export goods and services, but the free flow of data, it's not in anybody's interest to stop that. So I think the UK will sign up to the GDPR or something very similar. And I think free flow of data with the European Union will continue. And in that sense, Brexit won't affect us. In our case, we look at our business, and although we have customers from all over the world, all of them, apart from one, are processing data for UK customers. Okay. So that part of our business will be completely unaffected.
For example, back in January, one of Microsoft employees, the Microsoft lady, came out to say, it wasn't the company's view, said that Microsoft might move their data centers elsewhere in Europe if tariffs were too high. Microsoft has since then said this is not the case. But do you think Brexit actually poses a danger in terms of other big providers moving out of the UK? And when I say providers, not just competition, I mean cloud providers as well as big guys. Do you see a danger of UK losing a bit of its spotlight in Europe?
I think there's always a danger. As I say, in our case, our customers are processing UK data. So to the extent that the UK is a base for the whole of Europe, that's under threat. But if you look at what's happened with the big cloud providers, they were using Dublin as their European base. They weren't using the UK as a European center. So we've seen Amazon, Microsoft, Google come to the UK recently, but they're still using Ireland as their European base. So their investments in the UK are for UK customers.
And then, once this discussion starts between the EU and the UK, what sort of things would you like to be debated in Brussels, between Brussels and London when it comes to data centers, clouds, and even a little bit of data legislation? We know about Virginia, so maybe more on data centers and clouds, because usually they're not even mentioned, especially data centers.
No, but the business of data centers is data, so the GDPR is critical. As long as there's free flow of data, then I think the data center sector will be okay. I know that Tech UK is worried about employment, but a lot of people who work in our sector are from outside the UK. So that would be a concern as well. In our case, you know, we use those. It's all about staff, our UK staff, it's a problem for us.
And then we're going to the status of Sydney, so Europe's largest campus, 750,000 square feet. There's a lot of power going on around here, about 180 megawatts. What's the green energy sort of strategy that you have in place for this mega campus?
So we were actually the first data centre in the UK to be 100% green energy, and we still are. We've always bought our energy as green energy. You know, we have a variety of sort of smaller things we do, such as, you know, we have a cycle to work scheme, we have obviously all the lighting's on, it's automatic and so on. And we've looked at schemes such as solar panels, and that's something we will revisit. Unfortunately, the way the government has subsidised that scheme has changed and made that less economic, but we continue looking at green initiatives. And of course, low PUE, that's what data centres do, that's part of our core competencies, so it's part of our DNA.
Okay, and then on the business itself, well, because there's a lot of construction going around, a lot of refurbishments, etc. What's happening with next generation data now? So, what's the future for the next few months?
Yeah, we had a fantastic 2016. We sold something like 5 megawatts last year, and I think the London market did 40 or 45, so you can see that we had our fair share of growth last year. So we're about to announce our 2016 figures, which will probably show over 35% growth. And we're expecting the same in 2017. And interestingly, of that capacity we sold last year, most of it was actually sold after Brexit.
Okay.
So we certainly didn't see any Brexit effect there.
Okay, that's quite interesting. And then, of course, you're Wales-based, this data center in Newport. Are there any other UK locations that you're looking into, or you could be looking into, and even outside the UK, for example, as Brexit continues?
Yeah, I mean, not because of Brexit, but our backers are very interested in growth. What we have here, the assets we have, if you like, we know how to build and operate data centres, and we have a group of loyal customers. If we can find other data centres in the UK or abroad where we can exploit those assets, then we'll do that.
And then what would you say, to finish, what would you say are the main three trends driving your business today?
So firstly, cloud. There's no doubt about the growth coming from cloud, and that's pulled with it hybrid cloud. So we recently launched the Azure Express Route connection into the Microsoft Azure cloud. And that pulls in a lot of business from hybrid cloud customers. So they'll have a couple of racks of standard colocation, and the rest of their business goes in the cloud. So cloud and hybrid cloud, definitely. Onshoring of data, and this started before Brexit, but we've seen a lot of companies bringing their data back from overseas,
okay.
Even back from Ireland. You know, there's a feeling that UK companies want their data in the UK. And the third thing is definitely an increasing trend toward outsourcing. So your average corporate 10 years ago would have run their own data center. Now they're saying, look, we're not in the data center business, so we'll outsource. And that's a definite trend.
On the UK companies bringing the data back to the UK, are you noticing some sort of, I assume, strength in the data space? So then bringing the data back to the UK, the data sovereignty issues going around?
Definitely. And as I say, that was happening well before Brexit.
At least like a mirror of what's happening in other countries, generally everywhere else.
I think so, yeah. I mean, there was a few quite famous court cases in Microsoft, and then there was a Facebook case around privacy of data. And I think that scared a lot of people into realising that, you know, if your data is not in the UK, then it's maybe under the jurisdiction of other people's judges, and that's an uncomfortable place to be. So bring it back to the UK.
Okay, Nick, thanks for your time. Don't forget you can visit Data Economy on www.data-economy.com and follow us on Twitter, Facebook, and LinkedIn.